take that, Jaren. Why have you been stealing these?
I've been making this.
A house?
A home. This is where I grew up. At least what I can remember. What's a home like, Sydney?
Since when do lab rats wear Hugo Boss?
This is like something out of GQ.
How would you know? There must be $20,000 worth of designer clothes here.
It appears you have a fashion competitor, Miss Parker.
What's he up to, Sid?
Your form of expression, individuality, strength, showing off his colors the way a mating animal would.
You might be right about the mating part.
The Kama Sutra of love.
What's your boy learning from this?
I have always depended on the kindness of strangers.
Jared.
Isabella.
That chivalry was dead.
Only slightly wounded.
Do you prefer to be called escort or chickle?
Well, why don't you give me 1 hour and you tell me.
There are pretenders among us.
I was taken from my family.
36,000. He's already demonstrating more talent than any of our others.
How many people died because of what I thought up?
Since I broke out, I've spent every moment searching for my past.
He's a pretender. A genius who can become anyone that he wants to be.
The center wants him alive.
Preferably. He defends the weak and abused.
Life's a gift.
I am today.
Why leave all of this behind?
Jared operates on a different level than other people.
It all must mean something. It always does. Hey, you guys better come take a look at this. Follow me to 1500 Hart Street.
It seems pretty simple.
Let's find out.
You're cut.
The Kama Sutra come in handy?
I lent my copy to a friend.
Well, you must have memorized it. A gift from Isabella. What the hell you do to that woman?
I just listen.
I can't decide who gets you next.
I hear Cynthia Sloan is looking.
European countess to Detroit socialite?
Now, just because she's the only woman in Forbes 50 doesn't mean I can't satisfy her.
Remember, Jared, they're paying for a fantasy, not paying for a man. Do you think you can become someone else?
I'll do my best.
It spells out the terms of your employment. For obvious reasons, you're being hired as a,
special consultant.
Everything you see and do is strictly confidential.
Of course. It's quite a house.
You should see the other six.
Seven.
Hello. I'm Jared.
You sign? It's a requirement of Frank's. He oversees all my holdings and new ventures.
And which one am I?
You'd be a little of both.
Well, let the games begin.
Let's lay the ground rules. You're here for one reason. Men have a tendency to hit on me. You're going to save me the inconvenience. You're a prop, Jared, a piece of jewelry.
Oh, well, then I'll have to shine.
Well, for $5,000 a week, I expect you to blind me. You'll be on call until the ribbon cutting on Saturday.
For that?
Sloan Towers, the future of downtown Detroit.
Well, if this is the future, then this must be history. Edwards. The boy that fell from the fire escape.
He helped the birds. You're gonna be a veterinarian when you grow up.
I was a veterinarian once.
Can you make him fly again?
I don't know.
Tracy Johnson, you get off of this roof right now.
Gotta go.
Girl's gonna get herself killed. I run the neighborhood watch program in this building, and your face doesn't look familiar.
I was just trying to help the bird. I guess that Michael Edwards cared for them.
What do you know about Michael?
Just what I've read. This is where it happened.
I told that boy 1,000 times to stay out of this room.
My name is Jared.
I'm Alice Evans.
Nice to meet you, Alice Evans.
3 stories he fell straight down.
And then they condemned this place.
Now Cynthia Sloan can get her manicured claws on the only raw property left in the city.
Throw hundreds of families out of their homes. Fire escapes, they don't collapse under the weight of an 8-year-old boy.
The city said it was the weather. You know, I've been living down in 212 for nearly 40 years. Suddenly, the bricks start crumbling like sawdust? I don't think so. I only wish I'd been around to help them.
I can't take on another client. I'm at Cynthia Sloan's beck and call night and day.
Don't worry about it. This one sounds like a one-shot deal. But you're not gonna get away with talking this time. This one's got the itch.
The itch?
Go scratch it.
On the kindness of strangers.
What?
The service sent me.
The service, right. Oh, that was quick.
May I come in?
Yes, please. Would you come in?
Valentine's Day.
Help yourself. I made coffee. It's French roast.
Oh. How do you know what's inside of them?
Oh, you don't. That's the fun part.
Oh. Who is Valentine?
You know, they didn't say you'd be handsome and funny. The truth is, I've never done anything like this. Do I make the check out to you personally? Oops. Or do I make it out to the service?
We can figure that out later.
I'll make it out to cash.
I couldn't help but notice the man living over the garage.
Oh, that was Howard, my husband.
Your husband?
A soon-to-be ex. I mean, he's living above the garage until we settle things. Oh, I almost forgot. I bought a box at the drugstore. I mean, it was on special, so...
The 12-pack.
Safety first. Saw that on MTV.
You seem a little nervous, Joyce.
Nervous? No. No, not me.
I love a house with pictures. It makes it feel like a home.
I sent my last one off to college this year. Oh, I miss him. Can't say the same for Howard.
Was it another woman?
Oh, hardly. You know what Howard bought me for my 25th wedding anniversary? A toaster. I saved up and bought us tickets to Paris, kind of like a second honeymoon. Howard couldn't take off time from work, so he cashed in the tickets and bought a big screen TV. 50 inches. French roast is the closest I'll ever get to Paris. Now, I hear that I get what I pay for. So.
must miss your children.
Hmm? What?
Do they know?
No.
That you've hired a lover.
The accidental death of Michael Edwards led the city to condemn Jefferson Heights. These residents are protesting their eviction. In 4 days, their homes will be demolished. For some of them, it's deja vu. They tried the same thing after the fire of 77. The tenants fought then, and they won. Back then, the residents won renovation instead of demolition. But then they never had to deal with real estate mogul Cynthia Sloan. Ms. Sloan, can we get a statement from you today? My heart goes out to Michael Edwards and his family. But Jefferson Heights is dangerous. I'm doing the city and all the residents a favor. Some say that after Michael Edwards died, you strong-armed the city into a contract. Sloan Development won this bid fair and square. I make no excuses for being competitive. You do what it takes to close the deal. Whatever it takes. Miss Sloan.
Whatever it takes.
Specifically, Cupid.
Huh?
A corpulent infant who happens to be an archer goes around shooting arrows into people and suddenly they're in love?
That's about it.
And to show that love, people buy each other chocolates and other sweets. Do they want to be fat like the infant?
What was it you said you did for Miss Sloan?
Special consultant.
Sounds dangerous.
You have no idea.
Hi.
The address Jared left on the candy was to an adult bookstore?
You have got to be kidding me. Let's just get this over with. What's wrong, Bates?
Well, it's kind of embarrassing. I've never been in this kind of place before.
Right. And I'm the president of the PTA. It's all starting to come back to you, isn't it, Prince?
Jared must have brought us here for a reason.
It's called humiliation. Is there anybody here?
I'll be right with you.
We'd like to speak to the owner about a friend.
Rex is the owner. He's dead. I'm Bucky LaFontaine. I run the place. You mentioned something about a friend.
He left these.
Well, why didn't you say you were looking for Jared in the first place? Come on. Come on back. Anybody hungry? Yeah, Jared was a real emotional guy. Smart, though. He invented the portable smoke eater.
Are you sure you don't want me to grill you a wing?
Positive. Do you know where Jared went?
Not a clue. He just stopped coming in.
Would you say that he was interested in the material you sell?
No way. He wasn't into the sexuality part. He just wanted to talk about people. About what makes us want each other. You know, between you and me, I don't think that boy got much love growing up. I think that's why he must have been so proud of the book.
The book?
Yeah, I run a small publishing company on the side. Romance novels and such.
Are you saying Jared actually wrote one of these novels?
Yeah. There. He did the cover art, too. That boy's definitely one of a kind.
One is enough. This'll look stunning on him. Have this ready for tonight.
Not very big on pictures, are you? Now, you've got a lot of awards, but only one photograph. Photographs that make a house a home. Don't you think? Is this you?
Bred racehorses as a hobby.
Ouch. Well, that looks painful.
My prized steed threw me. I still have the scar. Used to be much worse, but the plastic surgeons keep whittling away at it.
So, where's your family?
You ask your clients this many questions.
Only the special ones. Don't you get lonely here?
I said he turned down a demolition plan. I've called a meeting.
I don't have time to get lonely. Don't be late tonight.
She was vaguely unfulfilled. What is wrong with you? She's a housewife. You nibble on her ear, she melts.
I don't know exactly what she wants.
Jared, if you call a plumber, you want your pipes fixed. She called a gigolo.
I understand, but...
Fix her pipes. And Jared, I don't want to have this conversation again. Right.
Just got her washed.
What do you think?
It's the car.
Drives her crazy. Joyce.
Hi there.
Rumor has it you're feeling vaguely unfulfilled.
I've been waiting for you.
You do realize that your husband is out in the garden.
I know.
You won't regret this later.
Hell with regrets.
number's 911.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
It's okay. It's strange, though.
Strange? What?
Well, you say your husband doesn't care about you anymore. Sure doesn't look that way to me.
I didn't mean to bite your head off. I thought you were another one of those inspectors.
Inspector? I don't think you'll be seeing many more of those. Your home is already condemned.
Are you kidding? These bureaucrats were all over this place, even before Mikey fell.
Somebody inspected the fire escape before it collapsed?
Yeah. He was independently wealthy, like you.
Like me?
He had one of those fancy hunks of metal on his wrist, too.
This?
Except his had diamonds.
Excuse me. I would like to propose a toast. First of all, to this work of art that some people call a building. The sign may say Sloan Tower, but this entire project was the dream of my right-hand man, Frank Linden. This has been his baby from the beginning, and if I don't give him a promotion for this, then I should fire myself. When everyone said that it couldn't be done, including me, Frank found a way. To Sloan Tower, whatever it takes.
Whatever it takes.
Like one of these? They're very good.
Have you ever tried one of these? It says, be mine.
Got one that says, you're fired.
Fired?
I'm tired of calls from this Hausfrau Column. You're through with her. And with Cynthia Sloan. I'm assigning a replacement.
Just before the ribbon cutting. You think that's smart? Cynthia Sloan is one of your prized clients.
Fine. You want to keep Cynthia? Then scratch the housewife's itch.
This is Sydney.
Why do people fall in love?
You might as well ask why the stars come out at night.
Everyone spends their whole life searching for that
special someone. That person to love. But when they finally find them, it all falls apart.
Paradox, isn't it? I believe it's better to have loved and lost than never to have loved at all.
So you believe that love is worth fighting for? That it's worth the pain and the effort?
Is that what you were trying to say in the romance novel you left for Miss Parkin?
The book speaks for itself, Sydney.
She felt consumed by a great void, a dark and silent abyss.
as terrifying as the grand palace around her. But somewhere in the chilling blackness, she caught a glimpse of a light. She remembered a time. The precocious little girl with a heart full of fire, a soul inflamed by passion, and a smile that could melt winter into spring. But the light was gone. The flame had died. Her past was taken from her by the soldiers of the great palace. She would continue searching, hoping to rekindle the fire. Until then, she would always be the saddest little Valentine. Joyce, this is Jared.
Come on in.
This isn't quite what I imagined.
Nothing ever is. Can I pour you a drink?
Yes, sure. Oh, that vibrates. Oh, my gosh.
We'll get to that later. Now it's just you. And me. No one can disturb us. Especially that annoying husband of yours. What's with you, Joyce? That's what you're here for. Don't tell me you're thinking about Howard. That husband doesn't deserve you.
I mean, how much polyester can one man wear anyway?
What?
And that physique? What is it? Body by chili dog.
Well, you know, Howard, he's a little chunky. He is.
Santa Claus is chunky. Howard, he's a zoning violation.
Well, you know, Howard has his faults, but he's a kind and gentle human being. And
he bought you a toaster for your anniversary.
Well,
he cashed in your tickets to Paris for a television set.
Well, 50 inches, actually. You know, that's just Howard.
Oh, forget about him. Forget about that whole night.
Well, you know, Jared, you just don't forget about 25 years of marriage. We've been through a lot. I mean, we raised a family. We,
made a home? You're right. You don't forget about 25 years in marriage. And you don't forget a home. Some people, they can go through their whole lives without ever having one.
What's wrong, Jared? You seem upset. You've been sitting here staring for hours. Tell me what's wrong.
Cindy, if you don't know everything, go down the hall! Go down the hall! Go down!
Eva!
so much anger.
Don't they realize it's not safe to live there anymore?
Well, that's easy for you to say. If this place started falling down, you'd have six others to choose from. They don't have what you have. Great education, rich parents, your own horses.
People change.
Some more than others.
Cynthia! Cynthia, are you watching this? They won't leave.
They can't.
I want your permission to call the police.
Oh, that would look great on the nightly news.
Please. Look, Cynthia, these people are breaking a city ordinance. Now, I can have Alderman Nance call the chief, set it all in motion.
Go talk to them. Tell them that their building is unsafe. Explain it to them face to face.
They won't listen.
Then call the police. Start a riot. Whatever it takes. Cynthia.
You the lady's gonna tear down my house? Jared said you like horses. I found this one when we moved in. It was in a secret hiding place. Wanna see?
Find just about anything if you know the right place to look for it.
Who are you?
Someone who believes that everyone deserves to have a home, even Cindy Morgan.
I changed my name, Jared, but I didn't hurt that little boy.
No, but you're partly responsible. Why are you so determined to destroy this place? It's where you grew up.
That was my past.
So you thought you could just get rid of it, like you got rid of your name or you got rid of that scar on your arm? Trust me, you can't cut a scar out of here. I've tried.
With all the houses that I own, that little room was the only place that I ever called home.
But now you're rich and you have this image to maintain.
When I was a kid, I won scholarships to very expensive schools. I was around a lot of very wealthy people.
So to fit in, you felt like you had to make up a life. Trust me, I know the feeling.
First, it was that my father bred racehorses instead of what he really did, which was drive rich tourists around downtown in his horse and buggy. Then it was my name, Elijah Snowball. Now it's too late for the truth.
Cindy. It's never too late for the truth. 2 tickets on the Concorde, please.
Hi, I'm your wife's gigolo.
So I have a deal for you. Celebrating, Frank, because today you were fired.
What the hell?
Hope you brought your golden parachute. Better hold on, Frank. You don't want to go down with your career. Sulfuric chloride. Ideal for the demolishing of a building. Murdering children. Cronies down in public housing say it was the weather. Right, Frank? You killed a child. Just so you could force people out of their homes. Just so you could make more money. You know, Frank, you are. This is where Michael Edwards plunged to his death. Just like you're about to do.
Help me, Jared. I can't hold on much longer.
Like you helped Michael Edwards?
I have money.
Well, I hate to tell you, Frank, but I'm not really a gigolo. So I can't be bought. But I am curious. How much? How much to throw hundreds of people out of their homes? How much to murder an innocent little boy?
I did it. I did it. Now, please. Help me.
nice watch.
Don't waste your time with those. Trust me.
I really know how to show a lady a good time, Jerry.
You haven't seen nothing yet.
Hey, you. Think he'll fly?
We'll see.
I'm gonna go chase it.
Is that allowed? I don't want to go back to that huge house by myself. It gets really lonely.
Over these renovation plans or what?
Whatever it takes. It's better to have loved and lost than ever to have loved at all. Do you believe that's true?
If you're lonely, call a 900 number.
Did you read my book?
I skimmed through it. You paint a pretty sad picture.
I just write the way I see it. How did we end up like this?
Like what?
Alone.
Searching. It's ironic because we both want the same things.
Someone to care about. Someone to care about us. Do you think we'll ever find that kind of love in our lives?
What the hell do you want from me, Jared?
Yeah.